That takes it to 1-1, ladies and gentlemen. Let's keep it rolling. Bout number four. Fighting out of the blue corner, Farid Habibi. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent fighting out of the red corner, Richard Mango Fanoos.
It was about busting raps and standing for something. Fucking acronym, cut the fucking act like you're happy. I'm fucking back again with another anthem. Why stop when it doesn't have to end? It ain't over till I say it's over. Enough when I say enough. Throw me to the wolves and close the gate up. I'm afraid of what'll happen to them wolves when the thought of being thrown into an alligator pit. I salivated.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to bout number four of the evening. This fight brought to you by Paw Patrol. 5x2 minute rounds, full tie rules, super lightweight division. Your referee in charge, Ilias Delapsis. Firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, train at a Rung Chai M60. A fight record of 19 wins, 19 fights, 13 wins, 2 coming by knockout. Representing New South Wales, ladies and gentlemen, Farid Habibi. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, trained out of the Super Fight Gym. A record of 19 fights, 12 wins and 1 draw. Representing Victoria, Richard Mango Fanoos.
Okay, red, blue corner, center ring. Red, blue, red, blue.
Oh. In a state of origin clash is 1-1.
5 rounds, 2 minutes, 4 tie rules. Fight strong, fight fair, obey my instructions at all times. Any questions? Touch gloves, good luck, let's go.
Elias just wiping about a kilo of the Thai oil off.
Okay, doesn't happen again, huh?
Richie Fanoos.
Mouth guard, mouth guard. Round one, chop!
Round one.
Big thanks to Paw Patrol getting behind us on about 4 of the evening.
So looking at both fighters quickly, physically, both look pretty evenly matched.
A bit of banter on Facebook last night that the boys are almost your brothers. Their facial features very similar. Of course, the name of the rat tail, Farid Habibi. We love a good rat tail here down in
Yeah,
Melbourne.
Absolutely. We are very impressed, Farid. That is very nice rat tail. First elbow already from Farid.
Yeah, Farid is looking very sharp. We know Richard takes a while to fire up. Boys right over the other side of the ring from where we're sitting, right in front of William Lou, WL Fight Photography. Get on and have a look at his work on Facebook or his own website, williamlou.com.au. One of the very best photographers in the business.
Gee, I'm impressed with both fighters so far, Johnny. Very sharp technique, not being wasteful at all. They tie up in a clinch now.
Good driving knees from both fighters, good control on the grapple there from Richard Fanoos. Farid, yeah, nice step up elbow as well from Farid, but just holds his ground and just throws the technique.
And now Richie's firing up, counting with a crossing elbow of his own. Looking at the clinch now, Farid just looks a little bit taller than Richie Fanoos.
Richie had a bit of trouble making weight last night, came in nearly 2 kilos heavier, which is a most unlike the boys down there at Super Fight.
Yeah, that's almost unheard of for the boys out of Super Fight Gym.
Yeah, one thing I like about already liking out of both of these fighters, Johnny Gadsden, they're both trained by excellent Muay Thai trainers. And as soon as someone throws a technique, their opponent is throwing something straight back.
Come on, blue, 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 blue. Mouth guard.
Round two.
Mouth guard, red, 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 red. Round two, chop.
So here we go, round number two. Victoria versus New South Wales. Richie Mango Fanoos and Farid Habibi.
This one's scheduled for five rounds.
So I was saying at the end of the first round, Johnny Kev, both boys, as soon as they get hit with something, they're striking straight back. And you can see the difference, Johnny. We're up at 19 fights each for both of these boys now. The technique is sublime.
Yeah, very impressive to watch. Look at that, both busy in the clinch. Richie now just trying to put Farid onto the canvas.
A nice low counter kick from Habib.
A crossing elbow from Habib. So he stated his intentions pretty early on in that first round.
And I tell you what, you don't do yourself any harm as a fighter if you come onto Rebellion Muay Thai and you like using the elbows. But it's all about 100% pure Muay Thai. And if you put on a good show, Sainazi will definitely have you back again. Don't worry about that. Just impressed with the knees of Habibi at the moment.
Yeah, but don't discount Richie Fanous. There he goes. He puts Farid onto the canvas.
Nice little takedown there from Fanous.
Yeah, he backs himself up and lets go that front kick as well. So tie up over in the red corner. Now they work their way out.
Beautiful knee there from Fanous just as he turned Habibi in.
Yeah, interesting how Richie's choosing to go straight up the midsection with most of his knees. Sorry, Richie's going to the rib cage, whereas Farid's tending to go straight up the middle into the midsection.
And that was an absolute knee fest, that round number two. Two down, three to go. This is Rebellion Muay Thai number seven. The Spinex eliminated number two.
Seconds out.
Come on, get that corner. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. Wipe it down. Mouth guard.
Round three.
Mouth guard. Oh. Okay, round three.
Oh. Round three, bout number four.
Richie Fanous in the red trunk. Farid Habibi representing New South Wales in the blue. Farid trying to take Richie to the canvas now. They tie up over in the neutral corner. A lot of clinching in this bout so far, Johnny.
Yeah, they've been very busy, and the difference, and as we said earlier on, Johnny Cav, you see boys at this skill level and experience level, they work. They really work hard in the grapple. Step up elbow again from Habibi.
Step up knee as well. Almost technique for technique trading. Neither fighter really been able to dominate.
And I don't know whether it's just the way it's panned out, Johnny Cav, but Richie Fanous seems to like working his way back into his red corner so he can hear the corner. That's where most of the fight's been, either been in centre ring or over in that corner.
It'd have hardly been over to our side at all.
Which is why I've got my glasses on at the moment, just so I can see what's going on. But this is a great fight, great technique. And again, there's that counter kick again from Habibi.
Step up across the elbow from Habibi. Now Richie pushes forward.
Tell you what, anyone watching this at home, this is what it's all about. This is good technique and good Muay Thai scoring from both fighters.
Yeah, good clean kick connecting all through this bout.
Yeah, there really has not been a wasted shot all fight.
Not a lot of boxing so far.
That's in the round number three.
Tell you what, Johnny Cav, absolutely action-packed as well. These boys have to stop on the start. And Rung Choi not looking too happy with young Farid as he goes back into the corner.
Twitter and Instagram.
Let's go, Red Blue. Come on, Red Blue, let's go.
The penultimate round. Round number four.
Mouthguard, Red. Okay.
Round number four or five, Johnny Cav, really enjoying this fight so far.
Yeah, this has been the most technical bout so far. And we're not even halfway through the card, so credit to both fighters. Oh, big flapping round kick from Farid.
And the people, Rung Thai was not happy with Farid as he walked back into the corner. I think he's expecting him to get a little bit more on the front foot. Beautiful knees there from Farid. Good counter knees again from Richie Fanous.
I'm pretty glad we're commentating this bout because I wouldn't like to be scoring it. Nice punch and knee combo from Farid.
The crowd's really enjoying this one as well. And Elias really hasn't had a lot to do. He's sitting back enjoying this. This is what Muay Thai is all about. The boys did not stop in the grapple there.
Yeah, absolutely. How many times do we see a referee have to step in, separate them in the grapple for just not working hard enough? But really, Elias hasn't had to do much at all. Now that's right above our commentary position. They've finally made their way over to this side of the ring.
For the first time in the fight, Johnny Campbell, we've got a really good view of the big driving knees from both boys.
Yeah, but I like the way that Farid just sets up these knee strikes with a couple of punch combos.
Farid just keeping Richie Fanous in the corner, but Richie just walked him out of it and takes him back over to his own corner. Just big driving knees from both boys. 10 seconds to go in this fourth round.
Oh, a couple of uppercuts from Farid.
That's in the round, yeah, number four.
Smile on the face of both boys. Rung Thai looking a little bit happier at the end of this fourth round.
Yeah, he does look a little happier with Farid's performance in that round. Warriors way,
proudly brought to you by Red Blue. What's the corner now?
Let's make some noise, ladies and gentlemen, for both these fighters.
Good.
As this is the fifth. Final round.
Here we go, the fifth and final round, proudly brought to you by the team down there at Paw Patrol, Johnny Camp. I'm on the fence for this one.
Yeah, like I said earlier in the last round, I'm glad we're commentating and not scoring because this is a very close fight. Both fighters have been busy, not wasteful at all. So expect now, really, in the fifth and final round for them to throw caution to the wind.
Yeah, Richie just forcing Farid back over into the red corner.
Don Miller almost pointing at the body parts of Farid Habibi, instructing Richie where to hit him with the knee strike.
And he's also giving him a bit of a smack on the back of the leg as well for not listening. You've got to love Donnie Miller and the O'Neill Ortega over there. Very passionate boys.
Yeah, and a big welcome back to Andy Ford Farlap, who's over in the red corner as well. Expect to see Andy back in the ring sometime in 2014.
Yeah, big stint over in Thailand. But I'll tell you what, these boys, I've lost count of how many knees they've thrown, and I reckon every single one of them has hit the mark.
Yeah, absolutely. And Farid continues to pepper straight up the middle, the midsection of Richie Fanous with the knees. And every time he hits him, I cringe. So all credit to Richie Fanous. He's as tough as nails. Good sharp punch combination from Farid. Just a break away from the clinch. Goes upstairs, high round kick. Step up, elbow, uppercut combo. Beautiful combination.
Yeah, Farid's really pulling out the technique, Johnny Kev. I'm glad I'm calling this one and I've enjoyed it. I'd hate to be judging this one. Oh, there you have it. Absolute quality. This is what Rebellion Muay Thai is all about. 100% pure Muay Thai. And great respect from both boys there in centre ring.
And once again, a big credit to our promoter, Sky Nancy, for matchmaking a fantastic fight.
Right here live on the Rebellion 7.
After five rounds of full tie rules, we have gone to the judges' scorecards. We have a unanimous points decision and taking their team to 2-1. Red corner, Richard.
Oh, there you
Mango
go. Unanimous points victory to Richie Fanous and the red corner. Oh, gee, almost. I would have felt that a draw would have been a fair result because it was such a great fight.
It was, and I'll tell you what, full credit to Fariza Bibi, looking a little bit bemused with the decision. But I tell you what, the Victorian out 2-1, but that was an absolutely sensational Muay Thai fight. A big thanks to Paul Patrol.